there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us only sky.
Hi, my name is Evan Gieb. I am from Team Graduate Complex. We decided to do our helping out, do our service at a program called Food Bank. They have many different branches. Mine was in Santa Barbara, California. And it was an eye-opener. I mean, first, I guess we didn't go straight to Food Bank. We were looking towards Meals and Wheels, and I think they had a tougher vetting process. Not a tougher, but just more time-consuming. It took about a week or two to go through the process, and with all of our busy schedules, we decided we wanted to jump right in, and the Food Bank was another great organization, and they were happy for us to come help out whenever we could make it work. And so we decided to go with Food Bank. They help out children, families, adults, seniors, anyone in need of good, healthy foods. I worked at the warehouse, which happened to be about 2 miles from where I live. Didn't know it was there, but it was great to be a part of it. I actually woke up a little earlier than I usually do. It was dark and actually really foggy the week I did it. And I'd get there and people would already be working, and half of them volunteers, half of them employees have been there for a while, and I was happy to help out wherever was needed. The first day, did a lot of cleaning. Everybody's doing a lot of cleaning. They had a fake health audit the next day, and the things that needed to get done were a lot of cleaning. They are held to a very high standard of cleanliness, and so the first day I did a lot of cleaning, a lot of food sorting. And the 2 days later I came in, they had done really well with their health inspection, but this day was more for having shoppers come in and essentially shop for their food. These are pre-vetted organizations that have people in need, and they can come shop for food at pennies on the dollar. And it was very nice to see these groups come in, be able to get as much canned food as they need, as much bread as they need. They were limited to the pounds of fruits and vegetables and meats, because at the time food bank had kind of a shortage on those items. But it was nice to see. It was nice to help out, be a part of that operation, and I know in the future I will be spend more time there, and you know, definitely help out where I can, and if not, just spread the word. I think that's very much needed for that operation. I'm looking forward to helping out in two different programs that I thought were great. One was the Brown Bag Lunch program, and this helps seniors, low-income seniors that benefit from a healthy lunch, and bag hundreds of brown bags of lunches full of fruits and vegetables, healthy stuff, go to churches, parking lots, a couple different locations, and hand them out. And I guess the employees at the food bank said that this is one of the more rewarding days, because you actually see a lot of the people that are that are getting the food, and they're really appreciative. A lot of thank yous and just a lot of happy faces to get those lunches. The other one that I thought was really good is the backpack program with low-income children and families, and they actually fill a normal, ordinary backpack with fruits, vegetables, all kinds of foods, and they give them to these kids at school at the end of the day, and to bring home to the families. They pick an ordinary backpack because they know some kids are mean, and if they, you know, they might get made fun of, oh, if they're taking, you know, free food or their kids in need. So I thought that was another great program, another great idea at the food bank. I'm happy to say that, you know, our team worked really well. We're all in pretty much different cities, but I think building off our project two and using the program Asana actually helped us out tremendously with scheduling the tasks, when they need to be done, how we're kind of moving through the project, and just communication. So I was very happy to see that and use Asana once more. But, you know, in summary, I think everyone had a great experience at Food Bank. I think that it was an eye-opener for everyone to see how much food goes through there, see how much food's wasted, and see, I think there can be some improvements, especially with word of mouth. And just maybe, you know, I think building off, I was speaking with Mark about the kind of not food requirements, but the requirements that says, you know, a lot of restaurants and other stuff can't really easily donate their leftovers. And I think, you know, there could be some work done with that side. But all in all, a great experience, and happy to have done it. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Mark Archer, and I am a student, an MBA candidate at Pepperdine's Graziadio School of Business and Management. And I just want to share my experience on one of the projects that our team did. Our team's name is Team Graduate Complex. Our mission was to go out into the local communities and to feed the hungry. And my experience was that I work as a military guard pilot with the Air National Guard at March Air Force Base in Riverside, California. And based on my schedule, I was kind of finding a little bit of a challenge to line my schedule up with the food bank in San Diego. One of my cohorts named Kaija Dankers, she actually had reached out to me and said, hey, there's an opening in LA, in Redondo Beach, Hermosa Beach. And so we actually teamed up. I went the next day. The sign-up was pretty easy. That's what I was most impressed with, is that these other projects or services require Social Security numbers, up to 13 pages of application. I literally just showed up that day, met with the director, and we started handing out food. I was very, very impressed. Where we went was the St. Paul's Methodist Church in Redondo Beach. And I was very impressed. I've been around the world with the U.S. Navy before I switched over to the Air National Guard, and I've been blessed to see both abundance. I mean, look where we're sitting right here. And I've also seen some poverty, so I've seen both sides of it.
So in summary, I got a great appreciation of what these food banks do. I'm still not convinced that the word or how these food banks work, because there's so many all over the region, probably all over the country. So I think that the first thing we need to do as an organization or as a group is to get the word out. I think the second thing is, I was talking to the distributor of this huge monster truck, and he's basically saying that all of this is based on local donations. He has to get rid of it. So the first thought I had was, we are full with abundance. I mean, look around again, with the backdrop of this beach. We're in one of the richest countries in the world. Yet here we are in California, producing half the vegetables and the fruits of the whole country. Yet 1 in 8 in Southern California struggle with enough food for their families. So that's the first thing, is just getting the word out. The second thing is, I think, and I'm no expert on this, but why can't we relax some of these rules? Why can't restaurants be permitted to take some of their expired food for the day and provide it to these homeless shelters? I think that's an interesting, you know, obstacle, and I think that would help alleviate some of these problems. So all in all, I was really moved. It impacted me probably for the rest of my life. I wasn't aware of what these food banks provide. I wasn't aware of the process, how easy it was to volunteer. I literally just showed up and started bagging fruits, and we did our first 6 hours and knocked that out. So overall, I was impressed, and I appreciate the exercise, not only what the school and Pepperdine show me, but as our organization with Graduate Complex, of what we can do, what we do as a team, as a group. That's it.
As Mark just told you, we volunteered at St. Paul's United Methodist Church in Redondo Beach, California for project needs. In March 1990, St. Paul's was asked to act as a counting station for the first ever homeless census count. Volunteers helped to serve warm meals and hand out clothing, blankets, and hygiene items. Through the interaction between church people and the homeless, many volunteers were made aware of the needs of the homeless in our local community. From this experience, Project Needs was created. Now Project Needs serves hot, home-cooked meals every Tuesday at 6 p.m. at the church to anyone who is hungry. They also have a food pantry that distributes groceries to families, homeless people, and veterans on the first and third Thursday of every month. Approximately 85 meals get served every Tuesday, and over 400 people benefit from the food pantry groceries every month. The food pantry does not only take donations of food, they accept food packaging materials, cleaning supplies, and other items to give out to the needy, such as baby supplies, school supplies for children, and toiletries. Financial contributions are also very necessary so that they can purchase the things that are in short supply or that are not donated. Mark and I worked at the food pantry shift on a Thursday morning. There were a lot of volunteers and everyone was very friendly. The volunteers were inspirational, especially those who volunteer regularly. Each of us was given latex gloves and assigned a certain food item to hand out. Since I was assigned to the apples, or fruit in general, we had to take the fruit out of the boxes from the donation truck and divvy them up into plastic bags that we gave to each person with a food coupon. We gave out groceries to roughly 200 people that morning. This included families with young children, elderly people, homeless, veterans, and those who have just fallen on hard times. The work was pretty difficult and fast, but it was amazing to see how kind and thankful these people were for such simple things as bread and fruit. Some of the older people were too fragile to carry the heavy loads of groceries given them, so a few of us helped them pack the groceries into their rolling carts or carried boxes of groceries to their cars. I overheard one veteran offering another veteran a ride home after they had both gotten to the end of the line, and that small offer from one stranger to another brought tears to my eyes. I felt privileged and thankful to have a home with a full fridge of groceries. Although it also made me angry to think of how much food and other items such as furniture and electronics get wasted in this country that could easily be donated to food banks that distribute them to those who cannot afford them. According to Feeding America, millions of pounds of food and groceries go to waste each year. To encourage companies and organizations to donate healthy food that would otherwise go to waste, they are protected from criminal and civil liability under the Good Samaritan Food Donation Act. I'll go into further detail about this in the conclusion of our presentation when we address our suggestions to help alleviate the hunger situation.
Hi class, Suzanne Franklin with Team Graduate Complex here. I volunteered at the San Diego Food Bank and was really struck by the size and scope of that organization. I had no idea that the San Diego Food Bank serves 400,000 needy individuals within San Diego County every month. That was extremely impressive to me. From the size of the facility, it's essentially a large warehouse, to the number of volunteers who come in and support every single day, I was pretty blown away. The second thing that made an impression on me was how easy it was to sign up. Initially, our team had chosen Meals on Wheels to support our mission, which is addressing the needs of hunger within our communities. And Meals on Wheels is a fantastic organization, but because of your direct engagement with the population of seniors, it requires a more lengthy vetting process, a background check, a longer orientation. And our team just wanted to get right to it. And we realized that through food banks, which every community has, and our team is geographically dispersed, we can more immediately engage because we're supporting more of the back office warehousing of packing and sorting donated goods. And these foodstuffs come from local growers. They're donated by local grocery stores. It's all completely donated, and then volunteer workers provide their time and services in helping sort the goods. And I had a really rewarding time volunteering. First, I was bagging and sorting oranges. I was cutting the bags and tying knots in the bags, and volunteers would come over and put oranges into the bags. And at the end of that day, at the end of that shift, we had bagged and sorted 4,200 pounds of oranges, which is no small thing. In the second shift that I did, I was packing boxes for seniors, and about the same amount of people as with around 30 other people, we sorted and boxed and packed 841 seniors' boxes. And so really, with just a couple hours of work, you're feeling like you've really been able to help those less fortunate than yourselves. Lastly, one of the things I was thinking about, how can organizations and businesses who choose to place social responsibility as one of their core business values or one of their tenets, how can they get involved? Well, really easily. In one of my shifts, it was clear there was a group of about 15 to 20 employees from, I think, a local insurance company. They were all wearing the same t-shirt. And clearly, they had chosen to set aside several hours of their time as a group. They seemed to be having a great time. And what a great way to, you know, build your team and also contribute back to society as an organization. So at the end of the day, I felt like this is something I would definitely do again. I was happy to find out how easy it was to get out there and get engaged. And also pleased to realize that this is something I can bring back to my organization as an idea for how we can, in teams, as individuals, but as a company, support our community. So I was really happy to get engaged in this project and have the opportunity to volunteer at the San Diego Food Bank.
Hi, this is Christy Hicks from Gainesville, Florida, and I'm going to talk to you about my experience volunteering at the food bank. So I volunteered at Bread of the Mighty Food Bank. This is a photo of a front of their building. So when you pull into the parking lot, this is what you'll see. So a little bit about Bread of the Mighty. They are a nonprofit organization. They were founded in 1987. And basically what they do is they collect, sort, store, and distribute donated food to 150 nonprofit organizations over 5 counties in Florida. Those counties include Alachua, Dixie, Gilchrist, Lafayette, and Levy County. These counties are some of the poorest counties in Florida. These agencies that obtain the food, they include churches, homeless shelters, pantries, and any other organizations related to feeding the hungry. So when you walk into Bread of the Mighty, this is what you'll see. If you look on the right-hand side, there's a row of gray freezers, and local retailers will donate perishable items. So when homeless people come into Bread of the Mighty, they're able to provide them with a meal. And their facility is set up like a grocery store, so it's very organized. Agencies can go down the aisles, pick up what they need, and they can be on their way. So their facility is about 20,000 square foot. They have about 2,600 square feet of freezer capacity. They have 11 trucks and vans on the road 5 days a week, picking up food from various locations. All their trucks were purchased by donations. One of their trucks was donated by the American Idol. They applied for a grant, and they were one out of 14 food banks that received a new truck from the American Idol Gives Back program, which I thought was really neat. Their food pickup locations include places like Publix supermarkets, Walmart, and several other wholesalers. These are some of the photos that I took while I was at their facility. On the upper left-hand corner is a picture of the truck donated by American Idol. On the upper right is a picture of their freezer. The lower pictures are pictures of inside their warehouse. And the lower left is a picture of their freezer donated by the Rotary Club. So their funding, they get personal donations, they get business donations, they get grants, and they also put on an event once a year. It's called Empty Bowls. And basically what they do is they serve their guests a simple meal consisting of soup and bread. Their guests receive a handcrafted bowl to take home as a reminder of the empty bowls on tables of families throughout our community. Ticket sales and a silent auction enables them to raise money. This is last year's event poster. In 2016, they had over 450 attendees and they raised over $80,000. This year, their goal is to raise over $100,000. So how can you become involved in an organization like the food bank? Well, first of all, you can donate. You can set up a drive, a food drive within your community. You can also volunteer your time. You can use your social media to increase awareness. And in businesses, they can encourage and support employee volunteer programs. They can accept donations on behalf of the organization. They can also collect food and offer incentives for their patrons that bring in food. And they can also raise money for that organization. How did this impact me as an individual? Well, first of all, I had a misconception of what food banks do. I always thought food banks was a place where low-income families can go to shop, but food banks are more of a distributor. I was also pleasantly surprised on the level of commitment of the employees. Every employee that I spoke to didn't think of this as a job, but a service to their community. Through this experience, it has inspired me to become more actively involved. I plan on returning to volunteer my time and bring my children as well. I plan on getting my community involved and donating as well. So this completes my presentation. I hope you learned a little more about Bread of the Mighty and how you can become more involved in helping our food banks. Now you'll hear about Katie's experience.
This experience impacted me in a lot of positive ways. I loved working as a team. The team I had was about 8 to 10 people, and it felt the energy was great, the end goal was great. We were working really hard and able to coordinate as a team at the food bank. It also felt wonderful to think that we were working and dedicating our time to someone other than ourselves. The other thing that really made me wake up, have a wake-up call, was that there's probably so many people out in the world right now doing this all the time, working hard, breaking their back, thinking that the work that they do is impacting someone other than themselves. That was really humbling, and I'm gonna be thinking about that for a while, and especially how I can raise my kids. Ways that it impacted me in a negative way was I hurt. I hurt for like a day after. I was so sore. It was really hard work getting all the food sorted and all the carrots bundled up and put in boxes. The other thing that I had that was negative during the time, like in the depths of my 6-hour shift, was feeling a little bit of resentment and wondering, of the people that I'm helping out now, are they doing something else to say thank you? Either to directly to the food bank or out in the universe, either a church group or just being a nice person. It just made me really wonder about it. And then I felt super hypocritical because I really hadn't thought about this before until I actually started volunteering at the food bank.
How can you help? First, you can encourage fellow coworkers to volunteer on nights or weekends. This is a great way for employees to bond out of the office. The company could even sponsor t-shirts for volunteers, which could serve as advertising as well as team bonding material. Also, if volunteer hours happen to be during business hours, ask your company leader whether employees can take turns volunteering. For example, at St. Paul's, they hand out food every other Thursday morning, so potentially a few employees could go volunteer, go into work late, and leave later that day so that they can still get in their 8 hours. The company could set up a rotating schedule so that each employee volunteers once every few months. This would appeal to those employees who are intimidated by a large time commitment. You can also ask local businesses such as grocery stores and restaurants to donate extra food to their local food bank. A lot of Americans are under the impression that restaurants cannot donate prepared food to the hungry, and I thought so too. However, I did a bit of research and discovered that in 1996, President Clinton signed the Bill Emerson Good Samaritan Food Donation Act, which protects restaurants that want to donate leftover food. It's amazing that this law has been in effect for over 20 years. How do more people not know about this? We should be advertising this everywhere. We live in one of the most abundant countries in the world. We should ensure that no one goes hungry. If you would like to volunteer at one of the organizations we featured, please go to our website for contact information, www.graduatecomplex.com.